Hey everyone, welcome back to another mining chamber video. In today's video we are going to be reviewing the RTX 3060 Ti. We finally were able to get one, so now we can go ahead and run it and see what this card is capable of. And just like we do with all of our GPU overviews, we're going to run through the profitability, the cost, availability, as well as the overclocks of this card and which coin you should be mining with it when you have it. So let's go ahead and roll the intro and then get into the video. Now before we start the video, we first want to go over a couple of things. So as some of you guys know already, we do post two different articles on miningchamber.com for the GPU overview, but we are deciding on remodeling it a little bit. So the way that we have our website currently, we have two different articles per GPU. One article is for the GPU overview, where we talk about the profitability, costs, as well as our conclusion about the GPU, and it also includes some of the mining rig builds that we make with that GPU. And then the other article will include the mining overclocks that we use, including some pictures, and usually it seems to be more focused towards one operating system. So now the new strategy is to combine them both together in one article, so that one article will have all the information you need. For example, for this video, the RTX 3060 Ti, you'll be able to go on there and then you'll find the overview, a little summary of it, and then additional notes, as well as different overclock settings for different algorithms. And then eventually we will add a way to submit your own overclocks, so you can add your overclocks here if we do approve of them, and then like that we can involve the community in a way, so it's pretty fun. And if you scroll more down, you'll be able to find the builds playlist, so it'll be the same thing. Just now we don't have any builds with this GPU, but eventually we will be adding some there. And then you'll find the related content as well. So this way it's more compact, more neat, and then there's less information but more to the point. So if you guys like this method or the one before, let me know please in the comments below. I would keep two articles if you guys want them like that, but if you guys rather shortening them out and keeping them in one article, also let me know down below and then we can make that happen. And the second thing is, if you guys have watched any of our other GPU overview videos, we used to use our main editing PC for test benching the new cards. So we would just take out our current GPU and then we would put in the new hardware and then test it out on there. But then that could lead to inaccuracy due to the wattage draws, because the system itself can draw more watts than the regular just mining motherboard and CPU. So now we decided to finally build a test bench specifically for testing different GPUs. And like that, we will be able to get more accurate numbers and it will be better for the viewer as well. So for this test bench, we're just using a regular Veta frame, and then we put in the power supply that we got with this GPU since we bought it as a combo, which we will cover shortly. And then for calculating the wattage, we will just be using a regular watt meter. So now let's go ahead and talk about the RTX 3060 Ti. So the thing we should first cover is the pricing of this GPU. So as you guys know, these cards are very hard to get and they're basically run out everywhere due to bots and scalpers that want to buy them and sell them for a higher price. So the original price of the RTX 3060 Ti is at $400 USD, but now if you go to Newegg or eBay, you will barely find any. And if you do find them, it might be at a jacked up price, or it might be paired with a combo, so you'd have to buy something else with it. For example, some RAM, PSU, or something like that, just like what we had to do. So as for the pricing, at what point you should buy it at, I recommend staying away from buying it on eBay at such high prices. Getting it at $150+ markup is not worth it. So it's better to wait for a good deal or until the stock is more available. What we did in our scenario, we used a Discord server that was recommended to us through a member in our Discord, which we are really grateful for. And that server basically gives you a notification whenever a retailer restocks on their GPUs. So as soon as we got that notification, we ended up going to Newegg, and the notification was for a Newegg combo. And we got this combo right here, which was for $515 USD, and it comes with a PSU as well as a GPU. So it's not so bad. You can sell the PSU and then you can have just the GPU, or you can just keep both of them like we did here, and we ended up using it for the test bench. So as for the models for the 3060 Ti and which model performs better than the other ones, I would recommend EVGA as the first option, and then I feel like the rest is the same. The Gigabyte ones can get a little bit oily and leak some oil, but as of the other ones, I still don't have enough information about them as which one is the best. If you've got a 3060 Ti, please let us know in the comments below how was your experience with it and how is the cooling with it. Since as for the cooling, I had no issues at all, because because the GPU uses very low amount of power, so therefore the heat won't be as much. And then also the fan noise is very low, even if you put it at 70%, 80%. It's a very quiet, and I feel like it's a really well-rounded card for cooling, performance, as well as the power draw. Now, after unboxing the 3060 Ti that we've got, we realized that it only takes one 8-pin, which is awesome. Always the less amount of pins that it takes, the easier it is to wire a lot together in one PSU. And of course, the looks of the card are phenomenal. I love how the Gigabyte one looks. It's really nice and clean, and as well as the RGB on it. Now let's talk about the profitability of this GPU and see how much money you can make using the RTX 3060 Ti GPUs. So for the profitability of the 3060 Ti, we are going to be using Cryptex mining calculator, which we will leave the link for in the descriptions below. And since no calculator has 3060 Ti as an option yet, as far as I've seen, we are going to be manually putting in the hash rate, which we did in here. So we put in a couple of algorithms hash rates that we've got from Serpent X Special Forces. He did a full video covering the 3060 Ti, and he tested almost every algorithm on it as well, which is really awesome of him. So this forum was very useful, and we are going to be leaving the link for this in the descriptions below as well, so make sure to check it out. So now if we go back to the calculator, we can see here we are going to be putting 10 cents kilowatt hour as the electricity price. So once we hit calculate, we will see the results down there. And now that the results are loaded, we can see here that Ethereum is the most profitable coin to mine with this GPU. And since it is the most profitable coin, in the overclocks section of this video, we are going to cover overclocks that work with Ethereum. And then for the rest of the coins, you guys will be able to find them eventually on our website. You will find them in this tab right here. So for now we have Kapow, and then eventually we'll have more different algorithms in here as well. So now let's go ahead and calculate how much money will you be making a month with this GPU. So if you're making every day $2.38 without electricity costs, and then after electricity costs, you're making $2.06. So per month, you'll be making almost around $60 in profits after electricity costs. And since the cost of this GPU was $500 plus tax, which would be probably around $550 with the bundle of the PSU, your break even is estimated to be at around 10 months, which is pretty awesome for this GPU. But of course, that is with the prices being at the point that they are now, and the profits remain as high as they are now. So now that we covered the profitability, let's go ahead and jump into setting up this GPU for mining, and as well as provide you with a couple of notes that will be helpful for you mining with this GPU. So for setting up this GPU for mining in Windows 10, all you'll have to do is just go to the Nvidia website and then install the latest drivers. So after you install the latest drivers for your GPU, you just want to install whatever overclocking tool that you like to use. In our case, we use MSI Afterburner. And then once you have your overclock tool installed, just go to our website, miningchamber.com, and then open up the 3060 Ti mining overclocks article, and then just put in the values that we have in here. So for your power limit, you will be doing a 60% power limit, and then you can try to go further down. But for us, 60% was a really good spot, and it was pretty stable on it too. And then for the core clock, you just want to drag it all the way down and reduce it as much as you can. For us, capped at -502, which should be the same for you. And then lastly, the memory clock, you can set that up at +1250. If you try to go a bit more, you can get a little bit more hash rate out of it. But the idea of these settings here is not to give you the best settings, since some cards can run at these and some cards can't. But this is just like a middle ground where you can place them in, and then hopefully it's going to be stable on them without any issues. So for the fan speed, like I mentioned, these GPUs run really quiet, so you can pump this up if you want. Unfortunately, you won't be able to see your memory temperatures since they don't have memory temp sensors, but you can see your core clock temperature, which is usually pretty low for these cards, and they don't get that hot either way. So just set the fan speed based on your own environment. If it's cold out there, you can just set it a little bit lower. If it's hot, just have it pumped up to 80 or 90, and then you should be set. Now with these overclocks, we used Phoenix Miner and it was stable for a while. And then we also used Cryptex software, which we plan to cover in the future. And we had it running on that for a couple of days and it was pretty stable and it didn't crash at all, which was really nice. And as for HiveOS, as you guys can see, we tried to use the same overclocks, but we did get invalid shares. So we tuned down the memory a little bit. And then the number does seem different here than Windows. That is because in HiveOS, when you want to overclock your Nvidia cards, if you point at this tooltip, you'll see here they'll say that the value is usually doubled than the one that is in Windows. So in Windows, we do around 1250. And in HiveOS, that means you would put 2500. But at 2500, we kept getting more rejected shares. So we ended up tuning it down a little bit. And now we are at 2380, which is more stable. And then for the power limit, we here use wattage instead of percent. percentage. We just capped it at 130 watts, which is the average of how much this GPU uses in Windows. And after that, it's been running pretty well. We had less rejected shares and it's been pretty stable so far. Although one more information about mining on HiveOS, you need to make sure that you install the latest NVIDIA drivers. So you'll need to SSH into your rig and then from there, just use the NVIDIA update command that they have and type in 455 to get the latest version. And then after that, you'll be able to mine with this GPU without any issues. All this additional information will also be found here. So if your overclocks are not being stable or you're getting more rejected shares, so just start incrementing down the memory clock until your GPU is stable. And then as well as the information for the memory clocks is 2x the value of Windows 10 in HiveOS. So you'd be putting, instead of 1250, you'd be putting 2500 in HiveOS. So the more information we find along the way, we'll be adding it here. And then you guys can use this information to your own needs. And for the power draw, we were using our power meter on the wall to calculate it. And as you guys can see, we are getting around 170 to 175 watts off the wall. Which surprisingly, it is accurate with the software. So on the software, we get around 125 to 130 watts for the GPU. And then off the wall, we get about 175. So if we take out the system watts, which is around 50 watts for the system, we are left with 125 watts, which is very accurate with the software. And apparently with NVIDIA cards, software is fairly accurate, but with AMD cards, it's not so accurate. Now, since we covered the overclocking, let me give you my conclusion on this card. I do think this GPU is a phenomenal GPU for mining. It's really good for performance, price, as well as efficiency. The only one negative about it is probably the how hard it is to get your hands on one of them for a decent price. So if you want to buy these now, you'll have to buy them through the eBay price unless you get lucky or you get some bots to buy you some of them. But in general, if you do find this for a retail price, then I would recommend getting it right away. It's a really good GPU for mining, probably one of the best GPUs to start off 2021 with. And then if Ethereum goes away, you still have other coins that you can mine on it, which is good for the diversity. So now that wraps up the video. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, let us know in the comments below, as well as your thoughts on this different way of doing it. Before, we used to do it only covering on Windows 10. So let me know if you want us to keep doing it like the way before, or if you want us to incorporate something else or add a little bit more information on a certain topic of the GPU. We don't get too technical in it. We just go through it and give you the most stable overclocks that you can use. And then you can optimize them based on your needs. If your GPU is crashing, then you would reduce a little bit. If your GPU is not crashing, you feel like you can push it a little bit more, you can just increase a little bit more on the overclocks. Now, that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and we hope you have a wonderful day.